You know, many of us are allergic to chemos. How many of you are allergic to chemos? Put up your hand. You are not for chaos, right? You want everything orderly. Right? Just imagine what everything is so orderly. Isn't it boring? Huh? Sometimes isn't it boring? How many of you love chaos? Some of you are not raising hands at all. You don't like orderliness, you don't like chaos. Then what is that? Huh? You know, in life you must accept both. Life poses both orderliness and chaos. Orderliness is a well-trimmed path. Chaos is like being in a forest. That what? They both have their values, right? So if you are at ease with both orderliness and chaos, nothing can put you off the track. Those who love chaos means those who are very rebellious, they rebel against everything, every order, every system. They tend to become so hard and they tend to become very negative. Have you noticed that? People who rebel against everything. Why do they rebel? They don't like authority. They don't like system. They don't like to be told what should be done, what is done, what is not done. Right? What you should do, what you should not do. Right? Especially teenagers. Correct? Right? You have that experience at home?
Yes. Yeah.
So, orderliness can be stifling sometimes. And chaos can be very unruly sometimes. They both have their advantages and disadvantages. And if you are in any one tank, in one side, you are about to get disturbed at some point or other. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
See, if you go to Spain, Latin America, life easy. Take life easily. I remember it. 20 years ago, when I went to, about 18 years back, 20, I went to Arizona. We were in the transit. We were given a boarding pass. The boarding pass indicated different number, and the board indicated